Welcome on Freedom Generation. Today we are happy to have Ellie Tom with us, who will be sharing a practical key on health beneficial keys.
Okay, the beneficial keys to health, the benefits of it. First of all, a healthy vessel is a happy vessel. And you're able to accomplish some things that you normally, being sick, wouldn't accomplish at all. Or you can continue to do things instead of breaking down prematurely for a lack of care. One of the main things this dealing with the preventable diseases that really got this epidemic going is a sedentary lifestyle. That means, you know, that couch potato, not doing nothing. So as mentioned earlier about things that we do what? Normally that we take for granted. And that's breathing, walking, and also stretching. To get up off the couch, get up off the chair, and to really start stretching the body, letting the heart breathe a lot better, letting the lungs breathe, and doing this continually, and stop letting your body live a sedentary lifestyle. There's an old saying that says, a flowing river does not stagnate. So likewise, you got these blood flows, these lymph flows, running throughout the body. You want to keep them not being so stagnant, because if you do, pretty soon what? Stiffness, then disease will build up in those areas. So this is constant and really what? Getting a habit and the flow of keeping your body moving. Now getting into Qigong exercises, there's many different Qigongs out there. And the word Qigong just means energy exercises. Now you're working with the energy, and that's our whole thing we've been talking about earlier, talking about frequencies, vibrations, sound, light, the different frequencies of the foods we eat, the different exercise, keeping everything flowing, the different thought processes we have, putting this whole thing together so that we can grow and be healthy and have a what? Higher frequency than the lower frequencies we thought we were supposed to carry before. Now the Qigong exercises, just to get you a few examples, just like how I'm sitting in this chair right now, do you know just holding the hands up like this for 5-10 minutes, especially if you're not used to it, is beneficial to the body? And you actually can feel over a period of time the Qi going throughout the hands, your breath dropping, just sitting here like this, something this simple. Then you can take it more like this. You can put the hand in many different positions. Keep the knees bent. And I'm just sitting in the chair to actually conduct this exercise. There's many examples of this since we're in the age of the internet, on the YouTube. There's many Qigongs that people will show you. The sitting down, the laying down, really running this energy. You can do it constantly. Your more advanced ones is when you are standing up, keeping your knees bent and putting your hands in different positions. You get up to 20 minutes a day will be real beneficial, raising your vibration and really helping with your health. So these are the beneficial benefits of health. And we're not even going into what? The benefits of longevity, really going for those goals, because right now there's a good saying that says, right now, there's a person that's born is actually going to what? Break the longevity record of what we used to that's born right now. Mm-hmm. So these benefits of health is real crucial. Anybody can get into it, find out what level you're in. If you're already on medication, I've run into this all the time where people want to, oh, I'm going to do this practice. I don't need to take this medication no more. Just cool down. It took a time period for you to what? Get on that medication. So I'm sure if you start working with yourself, talking to your doctor, there'll be some real good practices you can start incorporating into your lifestyle that will help with the what? the term of your health to get it back on track. In my book, I wrote about the homeostasis process, the balance, the energetic balancing act that the body does by nature. So when you're doing these qigongs and stuff like this, putting the body in different positions, holding it there for a while, letting the energy just run its natural course, you are taking part in a homeostasis process.
Elitum, when you speak about breathing, the fact that breathing is also a health beneficial key and can be also taken as exercise in our lifestyle, would you have something to show us in practice, please?
Breathing is actually awesome. To really get this breath regulated throughout the body and to turn it into a conscious exercise is a very awesome practice. Even in meditation, you know, you're there for a while, you will see that the breath will automatically drop. Because the saying goes, when we were babies, or when you look at a baby sleeping and breathing, is breathing out of the bottom of his abdomen. As we get older, for some reason, our breath rises. We got all this stress in the body, and we're breathing more out of our chest than having that body, that breath really drop into our core. So actually, to bring these practices back, to constantly start breathing with your core, you will find out that a lot of stress will clear out of the body. A lot of places that were numb, you know, by you breathing in that area, focusing there, will actually clear itself up. And all it took was a breath. To give you an example, it's basically just allowing the breath to normally drop into his core. Deep breathing. You can even do the counting process, like breathe in, wait for 10, then breathe out, wait for 10. And then really get that consciously going into your lifestyle. These practices don't have to be taken lightly. They really do work. On the internet, again, there's many different schools of thought dealing with the different breathing techniques that you can use. Really allowing that body to drop into the abdomen, because keep in mind that 80 to 90% of our sickness, illnesses, and diseases start in the colon. So having that breath work going into the colon, utilizing it throughout the body, will cause really great health benefits.
Elitum, so how often, in which frequency should we, you know, practice those four different points you mentioned of health beneficial keys? So I remind them, stretching, walking, breathing, and Qigong practice.
As we was talking about the seven principles earlier, and I said the second principle is exercise. The exercise should be incorporated into your lifestyle every day, which is very key, because what you're doing is you're doing maintenance on the body every day. So to take these practices from breathing, walking, stretching, and the different qigongs, depending on your schedule, pick the right time when you can utilize these practices every day. And like I said, life is constantly changing. You know, you might get a new job, new hours, dealing with your family situation, to pick that right time to really do maintenance on yourself. Because if you look at your body as being a piece of equipment, you're using it 24/7, yes, it needs some love and tender care so it can regenerate itself. So to consciously take on this endeavor to really start working with your being like this, it will give you more longevity in the long run and better usage.
Great. Thank you, Elitum, for this sharing on Freedom Generation. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Thanks.